Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Right, today's video, we're going to get very, very nostalgic because we're going to take a look at the evolution of my style, the evolution of EJ's style. Oh dear. So, I am a child of the 80s. I was born in 85, which does, in fact, make me 32 years young. Now, I was 0 to 5 in the 80s, so my fashion choices were not my own. They were all down to my mum, and maybe a little bit to my dad, if my mum could help it. Now, there was a lot of velvet involved, there was a lot of Victorian collars, and definitely a lot of volume. But again, all not my choices. Now, if we move on to the 90s, this of course is when I was growing up, and when I was going to school. So there was lots of leggings, ample amounts of leggings in every different colour, every different style. And I know you only think there's one style of leggings. No, because I discovered ample styles. And it was all about comfort. It was all about t-shirts, sweatshirts, you know, Disney designs, all that kind of thing. And that was very much my staple growing up. But it's as we move into the noughties that you can really kind of start to see my style properly evolve. Now, early noughties is when I was still at school. And as a lot of you will probably know by now, I grew up in Cornwall. So it was a very kind of surfy community. So I was very much into, you know, Roxy by Quiksilver, Billabong, Rip Curl, Volcom, any of those big surf brands. That is generally what I would have been wearing. I loved pastel colours. I pretty much lived in jeans, t-shirts. Wait, hang on a minute. I feel like I've gone full circle here. Jeans, t-shirts. Wait a minute. This sounds very familiar. Hoodies. Again, very familiar to my home attire. And flip-flops. Or in winter, it would be skate shoes. But it was all those kind of surfy brands. And you know what? There's nothing wrong with that. I was young and it was very much what was acceptable within the community and around my peers when I grew up. But that was very much my style. I had bleach blonde hair. I was quite scruffy looking, bit of a tomboy, always tanned. And all my jewellery was either made out of wood or shells. Yes, it was. Mummy wore lots of wood and shells, darling. But it was in the late noughties, 2007 to be precise, when I was at the tender age of 22. That is when I started my blog. EJ Style was founded. And this, I think, was the turning point for fashion and for style for me, because I had a job in retail, I worked in a shopping centre, so I was just surrounded by fashion. And it was no longer surf shops. This was high street stores like Topshop, H&M, Zara, Bershka. There was all of these different fashion brands. And for me, this just meant playtime. And for me, it was all about experimenting, because I feel like for the early stages of my life, I was very much this little surfer girl and there was no real fashion-y kind of element involved. It was more so all about the brand and all about just being comfortable. And so this was a whole new arena for me. It was just essentially a big playground and my time to really experiment. Oh, and experiment I did. There was so much colour. So I think I've said to you guys before, especially in my Q&A video, where I showed you guys my first flat, where me and Simon first moved in together. That's where the blog started. And that's where I started first doing my pictures. I had a blank wall and essentially I just had a compact camera that I put on self-timer, and I was actually able to crack out a lot of content, if you can call it content. I had this feature when my blog first started called The Daily Outfit, and this was essentially just an outfit every single day. And I would put together a lot of these outfits. I didn't always wear them, but it was just my way of experimenting and playing around with textures, a whole lot of colour. Hello, do you need some assistance? Would you like to come up? No? Oh, you want to play? And you do as well. This is inconvenient. Mummy's trying to film a video though. Yes, so I just did a whole lot of experimenting. But you know what? I don't regret these days. These days are the days where I needed to get that out of my system. I was super young. My body was smoking hot. You know, it was a day where I could get away with wearing a pair of sequin knickers and a jumper. that actually happened. Insert evidence here. And yeah, it was just, it was one of those things you do. I mean, we all remember a lot of the trends that came out throughout the noughties, and some of them were a bit cray cray, some of them were okay. And you know what? It doesn't hurt to try new things. It's all part of growing, it's all part of learning what you like. And that's what I did. So I blogged for a couple of years down in Plymouth, and then Simon and I decided we were gonna move back up to London. And I think this was a massive, massive turning point for me, because being in London, being in, I know it sounds cheesy, but the fashion capital of the UK, and such a quirky place for style as well. You can walk around London and there are so many different styles and characters. It's a really inspiring city to be in. I think this was a massive, massive game changer when it came to my style. So by this point now, I am in a new city, I have a new job, I'm in a new shopping centre, so I'm still being fed very much all this fashion constantly, 5 days a week. In fact, a lot of the time it was more than 5 days a week, because I worked 5 days a week, and then on my days off I tended to go into London and I walked up and down Oxford Street. I went to blogger events. Blogger events were starting to become a thing, and now because I lived in London, they were so much more accessible for me to get to. And I made lots of new friends who were now also interested in fashion. There was lots of bloggers that I started hooking up with. Not in that sense. Yeah, it was just a whole new world for me, and another new playground to start playing in and experimenting with. And again, I continued to experiment. So when Simon and I finally moved into this house, which again was another year and a half after we moved up to London, I then started doing my pictures outside. So I bought a DSLR, I had a remote for it, and I started doing my pictures outside in the garden. We had this hideous brown fence and this brown decking, but that was my backdrop, and it was easy for me to take pictures out there. But this again is where I started to experiment with colour, with lots and lots of trends, lots of different brands. And of course, as I was growing as a blogger, I was very much at the stage where you were being thrown lots of stuff for free. And when you're quite young and this starts happening and it's something completely new, you're like, wow, all this free stuff, regardless of what it looked like, can I just say? I would be like, yeah, of course. And there was no payment involved back in them days either. It was just brands were sending you free stuff. And well, I was loving life. Now, I think we all laugh about how I don't really dabble in much colour these days. I'm very much a kind of neutral palette kind of girl. I have the occasional bit of mustard in there, maybe a bit of red, sometimes a bit of pink if I'm feeling extra jazzy, but I'm very much a neutral palette kind of person. But back in the day, I did love a splash of colour. In fact, several splashes of colour. Now, along with experimenting with lots and lots of colour, I also wore a lot of dresses and a lot of skirts. And I know that we laugh about the fact that I barely ever wear dresses and skirts. In fact, I barely ever get changed out of jeans these days. But maybe this is why. Maybe I scarred myself from a few years ago. I wore maxi skirts, maxi dresses, tulip skirts, mini dresses, any kind of dress or skirt you can imagine. I have more than likely tried it at some point in my life. But again, finding your style is all about experimenting. And do you know what? There's a lot of these things on Pinterest, these little quote things. And I love them because I love Pinterest. And I have a whole board full of quotes and they're very inspiring, blah, blah. But there are some quotes which really irritate me. And it's the quotes that say things like, you can't create style, you're born with it. Of course you can create style. Style is all about being inspired. Style is about growing, and style is about an evolution of deciding what you like, what you don't like, and finally honing that to something that suits you and your lifestyle. So to say that you have to be born with style is absolute bollocks. Right, now obviously because I now lived in London, there was this whole spectacle of Fashion Week, and you guys now know, if you've read my blog post, I wrote a whole blog post on why I no longer attend Fashion Week. If you haven't read that, maybe go over and give that a read. I will leave a link to that in the description box below. Shameless plug for my blog there. Thank you very much. But yes, I used to attend Fashion Week and I used to love it for different reasons, even though I wasn't fully aware, maybe a little bit naive of the whole situation and the whole kind of circus, and maybe a bit completely oblivious to what other people were saying about those of us that went back in the day. But do you know what? It was fun. It was kind of like when you get to go to a wedding or a big event or something like that where you get to dress up. Fashion Week was that for me because I worked in retail, so day in, day out, I was very much in jeans, t-shirts. And so Fashion Week for me was the time where I really got to experiment with my style and maybe go a little bit extrovert. This is where all of the colour came out. This is where a lot of prints decided to come out. And these were outfits which maybe I wouldn't have worn on a day-to-day basis, but for Fashion Week, there were no rules. I mean, there's no rules in fashion anyway, but Fashion Week in particular, there was definitely no rules. I mean, there were a lot of interesting, I think interesting is the word, outfits to be seen on the streets and around the courtyard of Somerset House. Now, the biggest turning point for me and my style was definitely when I turned 30, and I'm sure lots of you guys out there will agree it was maybe the same for you. Turning 30 is such an important milestone, and it really, I don't know, it starts to form you as a person, and in turn, for me at least, it really started to form my style. I felt a little bit more sure of who I am. By this point, I had just got married. The blog had actually just started doing really well. I think by this point I had been full-time blogging for about 1.5 to 2 years, and it was only just starting to take off. And by take off, I mean I was starting to earn a decent wage where I could pay, you know, my full share of the bills and where I had extra money to spend. And this is also when my designer habits started to really come out, where I started to invest in designer handbags, designer shoes, and I started not shopping with brands like Primark, for example. And I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with Primark, it is all down to every individual's budget, but when I turned 30, it was almost like a conscious but not conscious decision to stop shopping in Primark and other such similar brands. And I think I just grew out of them, and instead I wanted to invest more in quality rather than quantity. I was spending a little bit more on my basics and those classic pieces. I discovered brands which I'd known about before, but I hadn't necessarily shopped in, maybe because my budget wouldn't allow, or in part, and I think this is a massive thing and a massive error that I made in my younger years, I looked at some brands and looked at them as older brands for like mums and older women. And actually it's those brands which have now become staples of mine. Jigsaw, Jaeger, M&S, a lot of brands who create really high quality clothing. And yes, some of the price pointing, depending on which brand you shop with, can be a little bit higher. But I've actually found now I'm in my 30s that it's worth it. And I don't feel old, I don't feel mumsy, I don't feel like a granny. Actually, these pieces are very sophisticated, they're very chic, and they can be mixed up with lots of my other bits of my wardrobe, like my denim. And I think there is a certain way to use sophisticated items to make it not so old. Now I say that, but I was still very much in love with the high street. I still wore brands like Mango, Topshop, Zara. I will forever be a high street girl, but as you guys now know, I like to mix in these high street pieces with designer elements like shoes, bags, accessories, and even those investment pieces like trench coats, biker jackets, maybe some more expensive denim. I think there's a way to work in all these items together to make them look, in general, more high-end. And it's definitely been over the last 3 years where you can start to see how this has happened. I mean, this morning I was sat at my laptop and I was just going through my Instagram account, and it's so funny how you can see how bit by bit my style has started to become, well, what you guys see today. So a few years ago, you know, there was a lot of blazers that started appearing on my feed, and obviously you guys know now I cannot function without a blazer. It is my staple piece. It's probably what I'm most known for, and it's the item which I have the most of in my wardrobe. But you could see them start to filter into my wardrobe. You could see them start to filter into my style and how they were becoming very much the staple that you see today. I also think that as you get older, your inspiration and where you get your inspiration from starts to shift. So when I was in my early 20s, I probably never ever would have looked at the likes of Jane Birkin and thought, oh my gosh, yes, that just wouldn't have been for me. Who was I looking at? Probably Britney Spears, I don't know, or Destiny's Child. Rock on, by the way. But yeah, I think as I've got older, I started looking at, you know, the heroines of yesteryear and these classic women throughout the decades who have really made a mark on fashion and on style, and their style has become iconic, I suppose you would say. And I think these women are the kind of women that now inspire me. And that brings us to present day and the Emma which you guys know and hopefully love and the style that you guys have become so familiar with. All those jeans, those t-shirts, those blazers, the gold jewelry. This is the process that I have gone through to get to this point of wearing all of these classics and these basics. So I hope you enjoyed today's video and a little walk down memory lane and all of those throwback photos. Do let me know if you've got a favourite past outfit of mine. Maybe you've seen it on Pinterest. Oh, I hate Pinterest because you can't delete that shit. Maybe you've seen it on Pinterest, maybe you've seen it on my Insta, maybe it's been on Google Images or even a blog post. Do let me know what your favourite is and I will see you guys next time. Bye! I feel a little bit more awake. I'm not normally this gentle. I need to use a cleanser. Quite a creamy...